That crusty stuff is actually just dried tears. Your tear glands are constantly watering your eyes to flush out irritants. While you're awake, the act of blinking wipes tears away before they can build up. But when your eyes are closed at night, the dried tears accumulate inside the corners. Goosebumps are produced by piloerection, a reflex that contracts the muscles around the base of each hair follicle, causing the hair to stand up and small bumps to emerge. Back when humans were hairier, piloerection had two benefits. It helped keep us warm by trapping heated air close to the skin, and in scary situations, it made us look bigger and more threatening, like a spooked cat puffing up its fur. Watching a horror flick in an air-conditioned theater provides the perfect setup for piloerection. You're not only frightened, you're also probably freezing. Here's the leading hypothesis. The top layer of your skin absorbs more water than the layers beneath, increasing its surface area. Since the newly baggy skin is still attached to the non-bloated layers, it bunches up, causing a prune-like effect. Fingers and toes are especially prone because of their thicker shell of dead keratin, an absorbent protein on the skin's outer layer. It doesn't just seem that way. The bloodsuckers are drawn to a tasty dinner by a variety of signals, including heat, carbon dioxide, movement, and the smell of skin secretions like lactic acid. One study even found that mosquitoes tend to prefer people who have recently downed a beer. No one knows what precise combination mosquitoes find the most irresistible, but if you seem to be their meal of choice, wear repellent and pass on the brew. Your nose helps perform a kind of climate control by heating and humidifying the air that you inhale so that it better matches the moist, warm conditions inside your lungs. Glands in your nose produce secretions that add moisture, and blood vessels in your nose dilate to warm the incoming air, acting like miniature radiators. When you breathe super frigid air, those phenomena are amplified, leading to runniness. There are two reasons why. Cold air tends to be drier, which causes the glands in your nose to produce more secretions. Second, when you exhale warm, moist air out into the cold world, some of the moisture condenses into droplets of air, which collect at the tip of the nose and add to the drip. Casual nibbling may have evolved as a type of self-grooming, like when an animal bites or scrapes down its claws. It may also be a soothing ritual for when you're stressed, similar to sucking your thumb. But some people take this habit too far, gnawing away until their nail beds are painful or bleeding. If you're over-chomping, seek the help of a doctor or cognitive behavioral therapist to help you break the habit. The George Costanza effect is a common sign of aging. It's caused by dihydrotestosterone, or DHT, a sex hormone to which some men are genetically predisposed to become sensitive. When that sensitivity develops, the hormone often causes the hair follicles on the head to shrink and follicles elsewhere, like on the back or in the ears or nasal passages, to become stimulated. A hiccup is an involuntary contraction of the diaphragm and the muscles between your ribs. Any short-term hiccuping is called a bout and is usually the result of overeating or drinking carbonated beverages. Other causes include sudden excitement, stress, or too much alcohol. Traditional remedies for bouts include holding your breath, sipping cold water, gargling, swallowing a teaspoon of dry sugar, gently pressing on your eyeballs, or leaning forward to compress your chest. If your hiccups last more than 48 hours, see a physician. An underlying medical problem, such as gastritis or inflammation of the stomach lining, might be causing them. These tears are caused by the release of a chemical called a lacrimator, which sounds like a supervillain but is actually from the Latin verb to cry. When you slice into an onion, the chemical is expelled into the air, and once it reaches your eyes and nose, it breaks down into irritating compounds that attack the nerve endings there. Your eyes produce tears, and likewise, your nose may run to rinse away these compounds. To reduce the effect, try pre-chilling onions in ice water for 30 to 60 minutes. This will slow the enzymatic reaction that releases the lacrimator, and that means fewer of the offending molecules circulating in the air and fewer tears. Typically, the culprit is your tongue, or to be more specific, the white film that builds up on your tongue while you sleep. It is estimated that 60% of halitosis cases can be attributed to bad-smelling sulfuric compounds produced by this layer of microorganisms and dead cells. The solution? Try regularly brushing your tongue back to front using a soft, bristled toothbrush. Most people lose 100 to 150 strands each day. The longer the strands, the more dramatic their appearance when you find them on your brush or in the drain. And if you don't brush or wash your hair every day, the loss will seem greater on days when you do. If you think you're losing an excessive amount, you're no longer able to style your hair as you normally would, for example, then see your doctor. You're most likely developing run-of-the-mill pattern baldness, which can affect both men and women. But there could be an underlying medical condition like lupus or a thyroid disorder at play. As anyone who's used a rolling suitcase knows, it's a lot easier to pull a heavy object along a flat surface than it is to pick one up. When you run on a treadmill, you're barely lifting any of your body weight up and down. Walking up a typical 45-degree staircase, on the other hand, requires you to move 70% of your body against gravity. The answer lies within the brain's cerebellum, which helps to monitor body movement. Scientists from University College in London found that the cerebellum can predict how self-administered touches will feel and alerts other tickle-sensitive areas of the brain. Since a truly successful tickle requires an element of surprise, this early warning system makes self-tickling an exercise in futility. Earwax is made up of moisturizing oils, infection-fighting enzymes, and dead skin. And though the substance may be unsavory, most of the time we should let our earwax be. When you try to remove it using Q-tips or your finger, the result is like packing a musket. You keep pushing the earwax in deeper, where it gets stuck and hardens. Instead, Clean your ears while showering by gently tugging the lobes, which straightens the ear canal and allows water to wash away excess wax. We know that fingernails grow about 3 times as fast as toenails, and that the fingernails of your dominant hand grow more rapidly than those of your non-dominant hand. What we don't know for sure is why. The most accepted theory is that since you use your fingers more than your toes and your strong hand more than your weak one, the faster nail growth might result from the body's attempt to repair whichever parts are undergoing the most trauma from activities like pecking out texts or digging for car keys. The older you are, the more likely you are to develop arthritis. The Arthritis Foundation estimates that 27 million Americans suffer from the most common form, osteoarthritis, which is caused when cartilage, which is the connective tissue that cushions our joints, begins to break down. Without this protective padding, bones can rub together, causing stiffness and pain. Older adults are also more likely to develop a condition called bursitis, in which the bursa are the fluid-filled sacs that reduce friction where tendons slide over bones, become inflamed. The good news? Increasing your activity level may make the symptoms milder and help you feel better.